Hello, my name is Shane O'Regan and I am the director for iCON Build, based out of our factory here in Heerbrugg, Switzerland. Welcome to our latest update for the Leica iCON Field software version 8.5. With this version, we have new features and improvements to enhance your workflows and user experience. One of the key areas that we reworked in this version is one of our original and most used applications, sketching, to include auto snapping, continual checks to existing points, plus a reworked undo and redo process to make the app more powerful than ever before. In 8.5, we have enhanced our IFC workflow so that you can now not only select the surface and see its slope direction and information, you can now stake one or multiple surfaces, ensuring that you can check slabs during and after construction, plus generate a report to show the overall deltas to those slopes. With 8.5, we've also extended our shift point functionality for as-built, enabling you to measure multiple points with a defined offset, further enhancing your as-built and final delivery of finished data for your projects. We also introduced a new option in the setup process to give you the choice to either automatically use the target type and height for your control points, or to have the option to manually adapt these to suit your project environment, which is ideal, especially when you need to set up utilizing your detail pole. Plus, we've updated our custom prism types to give you a continual and visible indicator of which prism type you've used to avoid any potential errors in measurements or layout later on. For more details about these and our other features, please visit our website or get in touch with your local Leica Geosystems representative.
In this version, we reworked one of our original and most used applications, sketching. We have reworked our undo and redo functionality, including linking the behavior to other tools, such as close figure, allowing you to quickly undo any incorrect entries without having to start over or reselect the point that you want to use. We introduced automatic snapping and point detection for connecting to existing points. If your new point is at the exact distance of an existing point, then the app will inform you and snap to that exact point. If your dimensions don't exactly connect with the existing point, then the app will tell you that you are close to the point and by how far. When sketching in 3D, we will now also do a height check to avoid clashes with an existing base point. When you set the distance and angle to zero, the software will compare the height of the existing point to the new sketched one. If they match, we will give you a warning and then simply update the height value to the correct one and carry on with your data creation. These improvements make the sketching app stand out even more than before, with an improved super fast workflow and continual checks throughout the process to avoid potential mistakes that may not have been spotted before. With 8.5, not only is your sketching improved, your whole layout process is. In our last version, we introduced the IFC slope indicator, which is an ideal tool when working with multiple shallow slopes, for example, for concrete drainage. In 8.5, we have enhanced that workflow so that you can now not only select a surface, you can now stake to one or multiple surfaces, ensuring that you can check the slabs during and after construction and generate a report to show the overall deltas to the slopes. For concrete construction, this now gives an excellent workflow, especially for shallow sloping elements, to ensure that they are built to the correct grade and tolerances defined. When carrying out as-builts on site, it is sometimes required to measure with an offset to capture the true detail of the constructed elements. For example, a column center or midline of a wall. With 8.5, you can now enter an offset value, and if you want it to apply to multiple points, you can use the lock icon, and then all the points will be stored with that offset value. Once you are finished, you can tap the offset indicator and cancel the shift to return back to the normal measurement mode. This enables you to carry out and complete as-builts quicker and with more detail than before. Working on projects often means that we might need to be dynamic when setting up the total station before we start our work package. In this version, we have introduced a checkbox. Use predefined control point settings that gives you full control over how you want to set up to your control points. For example, if you use your pole and prism for setups and need to walk to each point, then unticking the box will give you the flexibility to enter the pole height and prism type you use that day. However, if you use our automated setups or your control targets are fixed, then keeping the checkbox ticked will use all the information about your stored control, including the prism type and height, for the setup process. This gives you the full flexibility to adapt to your project situation without the need to edit or create new control point and get to the tasks that are more important to you. We know when working on projects that sometimes you need to work with a user-defined or custom prism. With 8.5, we have introduced a number indicator in both the prism selection option and in the status bar. This makes it much easier to identify and select the correct user prism, minimizing potential errors and giving more confidence to speed up your workflow on site.